Hello children, children, last week we have finished unit 3, that is safety matters. Today we are going to start with a new unit. So take out your moral science books, take out page number 21. On page number 21 we are going to start with unit 4, that is be gentle. Before we start reading this lesson children, let me explain you what is the meaning of gentle. Children, what is the meaning of gentle? Gentle means when we are kind to others. When we are kind to others. When we speak politely with others. When we help others in need. When we don't fight with others. When we console somebody. When we give happiness to somebody. When we console somebody when somebody is sad. When we are respecting our parents, our grandparents, our teachers, everybody, whether he is younger to us or elder to us, your brother and sister, when we are giving love to everyone, when we are showing respect to everyone, that is called gentleness. That is the meaning of gentle. Now let's start reading this lesson. Gentleness is the act of dealing with others. Means how you deal with others. How you behave with others. If you are fighting with others, or if you are not obeying them, or if you are using harsh words with others, that doesn't mean you are a gentle person. No. If you are speaking politely with others, and you love others, you respect others, that is called gentleness. Means how you behave with others, that is called gentleness. It means to be calm and quiet. Means when you behave calmly, means you are very quiet and you are very soft spoken. That is called gentleness. One who is gentle will not have any ill feeling against others. A person who is gentle, children, can never think bad of others. A person who is gentle can never think bad of others. Even if a person does something wrong to that person who is gentle, even then he will not think bad of that person, even if he has done wrong to him. Because he is a gentle person, he will always think that something good should happen with that person, that everybody should be in a good condition, everybody should live happily. That is the quality of a gentle person. A gentle person usually keeps himself away from anger, jealousy and envy. Means a gentle person never ever gets angry with others. He never gets angry with others. If somebody does wrong to him, might be he gets angry, but he will control his anger. He will control his anger. And he never feels jealous of others. Like if somebody is having a big car, he will not feel, a gentle person will not feel, why he is having such a big car, why I am not having. So he will not think of these things. He will not be jealous of others. Like suppose you children are studying in a class. If one child comes first in the class and the other child, why he came first in the class? I should come first in the class. This feeling of jealousy is not there in a gentle person. If you are a gentle person, you will obviously think that if he has come first in the class, good, very good. Next time I will also work hard to come first in the class. You will not feel jealous of that person. But you will feel happy for that person who stood at first position in the class. And envy means he will not think that he is my enemy or he is my enemy, I don't like him, he is my enemy, I will not talk to that person. A gentle person is away from all these kinds of things. He doesn't feel anger, he doesn't feel jealousy, and he is not envy of others. He will be polite and good mannered. Means that gentle person is always polite with others and he is a good mannered person. Means well mannered person. It is true that when we give something, we will get it back. Children, obviously, there's a saying, give respect and take respect. Whatever you will give, if you are disobeying your teachers, obviously a time will come when you will also be disobeyed by someone. If you are disobeying your parents or you are using harsh words with your parents, obviously a day will come when your children will also disobey you and their children will also use harsh words for you. They will also not speak politely with you. So whatever we give, the same thing we get back in future. Might be we will get it after 10 years or 20 years, It will take time, but definitely whatever we give, that comes back to us. If we are good to others, they too will be good to us. If we are good to others, children, obviously God is watching everyone. If we are good to others, obviously God will also give good in return. He will not give us bad in return. He is watching everybody. If we are doing good for others, obviously God will do good for us also. Next is, I am gentle. Now, children, here we are going to read the ways how we can be gentle. Children, these can come in the form of fill-ups also. Like here also, I have underlined few sentences. And the where I have underlined with two lines, that can be the fill-ups. So here, you can learn these fill-ups also from the book itself. And these sentences also can come in the form of fill-ups in the exams. So now, these are the ways through which we can be gentle. I don't use harsh words. A gentle person never uses harsh words. A gentle person never uses harsh words. Means he doesn't abuse anyone. He doesn't use any wrong words for anyone. He's always polite with others. I don't quarrel with others. Quarrel means fight. I don't fight with anyone. A gentle person never fights with anyone. I forgive the mistakes of others. Like if somebody has done wrong to you and you are feeling very bad, it doesn't mean that you will also do wrong to that person. You will obviously, if you are gentle, you will obviously forgive that person who has done wrong to you. A gentle person always forgives the person who has done wrong to him. Obviously, like suppose at home also, you people, children make mistakes. And what do the parents do? Do they forgive their children? Yes. First of all, they teach their children, beta, this is right and this is wrong. Don't do this and don't do that. Whatever is right, they teach you. And if you are doing something wrong, obviously they will scold you. And it doesn't mean that your parents will stop talking to you if you are doing something wrong. Means they are gentle people. Your parents are gentle, yet they are teaching you right, what is right and wrong. And they will forgive you if you have made any mistake and teach you that don't repeat this mistake again in future. I try to help and support others. Means a gentle person always tries to help and support others when they are in need. If somebody is in a problem, obviously a gentle person always offers help to that needy person. I want to spread peace and happiness. A gentle person always spreads peace and happiness. He doesn't fight with anyone. He is not annoyed with anyone. He doesn't feel anger with anyone. He is not angry with anyone. He always spreads peace and happiness to others. He always gives happiness to others. If somebody is sad also, then also he tries to make him happy. Like suppose in the school, if one of your classmates is not feeling happy, obviously you will go to that classmate and you will ask him why you are sad, why you are crying, and you will try to console that person. So means in a way you are trying to give happiness to that person. Okay, but okay friend, don't worry, I will help you. If that child is not able to solve any sum in the class, so obviously after that period you will try to help that child. Means you are in a way giving happiness to that child, you are helping that child. I console those who are sad. Means a gentle person always tries to console. Always, if somebody is sad and not feeling happy, obviously, if a gentle person will go to that person and try to console that person. Next is, I love and respect everybody. A gentle person always loves others. And he always gives respect to everyone, whether that person is younger to him or elder to him. Like children, you must be having your younger brother and sister. If you are scolding them and fighting with them every time and show that you are elder to your brother and sister and you can do anything, no, that is wrong. You should be gentle. You should love your younger brother and sister and give respect to your elders, your parents, your grandparents, your uncle, your aunt, your friends. You should give respect to everyone. So this shows that you are gentle. Next is, I don't cause others pain and discomfort. Means a gentle person never ever harms anybody. Never ever hurts anybody. Never gives pain to everyone. never thinks that he has done wrong with me, I will also give him pain. So this is wrong. A gentle person never does these things. He is always trying to give happiness to others. He is always trying to help others. He is always trying to help the people who are sad. So he always gives respect to his elders and the younger ones too. So children, these are the various ways in which a gentle person behaves. So in this video, I will teach you till here. In the next video, we will continue with this lesson. Thank you.